In this video, I'm going to turn this hexagon coaster that I made into a round coaster. Now, this was a request from a viewer, so these are the steps I would take to do that. So if you want to make this, and you will probably need to make this in order to make this round, we've got another video on that, so just check the link in the description below. So just move it out of the way and come over to the circle option in the menu here, and I'm going to draw a circle. So I'm going to hold the shift key down while I do this, so it turns into a perfect circle. And you really want to make this the size that you want your final coaster to be. So now what we want to do is, I'm just going to give it a different color first of all, just to distinguish it from here. So I'm just going to change it to that color. And I'm going to make a duplicate of this. So to do that, I'm just going to press Command D on my keyboard, or Control D if you're on a Windows. So, and then I'm just going to move the top layer out. So I'm just going to click on the Select tool and just drag out that top layer. Move it over there. Okay, so we've got our original here. And what we want to do is we want to create an offset. So I've come down to offset shapes, click on that, and you want to make this the thickness that you want for your coaster. And you can change that by moving the up and down arrows here. So I might just go with what was there, that's fine. But we want the direction to be inward. So just click inward and go OK. And I'm going to group these. So I'm just going to drag from the right here and just to select everything, and then I'm just going to right click and group. Okay, so that's ready to go. Now what I need to do is just bring over my original hexagon shape, bring it over and lay it over the top of this one. Now what I want it to do is I want every little point on these hexagons to overlap. So I just got to make sure it's big enough. So I might just drag a little bit from the sides here, just to make sure everything is overlapping. What I'm going to do is highlight everything and come up here to click this option up here, and what this will do is align everything both vertically and horizontally, so make sure everything is centered. So I'm going to click there, okay, and then I'll click away, and I'm just going to see if everything is overlapping. You can see these points. I want every point to make sure it's just slightly overlapping. Doesn't matter that these ones are overlapping the outer circle, we'll fix that in a minute. So that's fine for me. So what I'm going to do is going to highlight everything and come down and click on this second option here, the Boolean Union option. Okay, so it's all combined there. Now you'll see we've got all these edges aren't quite right here, so we need to fix that. And to do that, what we need to do is click on the shape, then right click and come down and ungroup. Now that it's ungrouped, we can click on this outer line and we can drag it out or just delete it. I mean, you can just press the delete key, but I'll drag it out so you can see that there. And I'm just going to press the delete key on my keyboard. Okay, so now all of this here is all in little bits and pieces, so we need to group it. Now if you've ended up with some odd little shapes, you might, depending on how you centered this, you might have some other little shapes. You can just click on them and delete them. For example, here you might want to click on that and delete it if you don't want all those little shapes. It's up to you how you do this, but I'm leaving them in. Okay, now we need to group them. So I'm right clicking and dragging to highlight everything, and then right click and group. And then we can bring our other piece over the top now. And what I'm going to do is just highlight both and then come up to do that center option again, so it centers everything. Okay, so there we go. So I'm just going to change the color of this to black so that they're all black now. And then highlight everything, right click and group. And there you go. Now you have a circle shaped hexagon coaster. So thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this tutorial, please give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more.